Biomimicry. Now, what is that? Well, in the realm of technology and science, there's a field of study, and it's pretty popular these days. It's called biomimicry. The word biomimicry comes from two Greek words, bios meaning life, like biology, and mimesis meaning to imitate or to mimic. You see, therefore, biomimicry means the imitation of life. And this field of study looks at certain things in nature, and it attempts to use those designs and structures in nature to create technology that's helpful to humans. Now, the list of things included under the term biomimicry is very long. Recently, scientists have begun to develop a tiny flying robot that mimics a fly. Now, interestingly, it's about the same size and weight of a fat housefly. And they've come up with a lot of uses for this. They say this robo-fly could help firefighters locate people during fires or spy on potential terrorists. Now, why would anyone want to copy a fly? And the reason's really simple. Flies are some of the most well-designed flyers in the world. Ron Fearing, the scientist behind a lot of the research on RoboFly, said that flies are the fighter jets of the animal kingdom. They can change speed and direction in a fraction of a second, and they can even land upside down. Just try catching one with your hand to see how great they are at flying, Dr. Fearing said. He also said there are all kinds of things nature can do that we don't know how to do yet. Dr. Fearing and many of the people who study biomimicry conclude that these wonderful designs and structures are the result of evolution. But that doesn't make any sense. If humans who are very intelligent have not been able to create designs and structures as efficient as those in nature, then how could evolution have done it? By blind chance and accident? Doesn't it make much better sense to believe that God, the great designer of the universe, created the fighter jets of the animal kingdom with all their amazing designs? Isn't it amazing how God's design, found in a common housefly, is better than some of the technology found in our most advanced jet airplanes? The Apostle Paul had it right when he said, "The foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men." You see, the entire field of biomimicry proves that there is a designer in nature, and that designer is God.